And now, Mickey Mouse proudly presents The Mouse Factory.
Nature lovers, and welcome to the Mouse Factory. I'm Dom DeLuise, and as you see, I'm supposed to be the great outdoors type. And if you think that this outfit looks ridiculous, wait until you see what else they got me wearing. What are you doing? Oh, you silly goose. What are you doing? You're fishing the old-fashioned hunkerberry fin way? That's wrong. You can't. I thought bears were supposed to know something about fishing. This is a worm on a hook?
No, no, no. That's wrong.
Wrong. I'm an expert. Watch me right here. Lesson number one. You fit the lure to the fish. Now, right here is what we use in case you're after trout. Trout is very vain, you see. So you get a mirror just like that. He comes up to give himself a kiss. Ba-ba-ba-boom! We got him. And if you are interested in getting a catfish, here's what we use right here. A mouse fish. Of course, I'm not taking any chances today because I am going to do a little fly casting. Get it? Fly casting? Forget it. Okay, here we go. It's all in the wrist. One, two, three. Look at that. Oh, is that a good... Why? Don't believe it. Oh, that's... Ooh, that's... Ooh. Could you give me a hand, please? It's... Whoa. It's... Ooh, ooh. That's... How? One last tip. If nothing else works, hire your local fishing bear. As much as I hate to admit it, the bear is one of nature's finest fishermen. No limit to the catch. And if he loses one, he just grabs another. I don't know how they do it. No tackle, no expensive equipment. He just wades right in and takes his pick. I hate him. Even their kids learn to fish before they learn to walk. And so what if he's fishing out of season? Let's face it, what game warden is going to ask to see his license? Well, if you can't beat him, join him. I would like to have a bass and a trout to go, please. Oh, Goofy, my prize pupil. Are we ready to go on our first fishing trip? Good. He'll be all right if he follows my advice. Remember what you're up against. The trout is alert, intelligent, a fighter of the first water, rugged, and all that stuff. The big trick is to sneak up on him. That's it. Slip up quietly and don't let him see you coming. Look out for that cliff! Boy, now you've done it. Once the pool is disturbed, the sensitive trout just aren't going to bite, you dum-dum. The fly fisherman must know how his tackle is going to appear to the fish. So let's take a peek at how you look through the eyes of the fish. I don't blame them. You do look ridiculous. When casting the lure, it's important to remember how to avoid overhanging brush and limbs. Swing your arms in a liquid, rhythmical movement. That's it! Straight as an arrow! Skim over the water and land lightly in that deep, beautiful pool. Wow! That was a perfect cast! The line sings, and the poor fish is really hooked. Of course, there's nothing like lake fishing for pure pleasure. Letting the line fall where it may. Hey! Hey, I think you got a strike! A strike! Oh, wow! A real whopper! Don't get excited. Don't get excited. What a fighter! Look at that pole bend! Hear the reel sink. Don't give in. Hang on there. You got him. You got him. That's it. That's it. Play him. Play him. Keep cool. Use your head. Use your head. Hang on. Wow, look at him go. None of my pupils go home empty-handed. Let's see. How about a nice, fat flounder, huh? Or a holy mackerel? Just asking. Did you know that a small deep-sea fish called a black swallower can swallow another fish up to 3 times his size? Really? Oh, I find that hard to swallow. Oh, hello there, and welcome to the busiest little airport in the country. Oh, hello. Yes, flight 371. Check your air speed. Check your air... You've already landed? Well, check your ground speed. Over and out. As you can see, I'm responsible for hundreds of flights. And believe me, it's not easy. Okay, flight 290. How many times have I told you? No instrument landings. Please. Phew. Honestly, my life is just a series of split-second decisions. It's one... It's a crisis. After another. .503, please hit your air brakes. Oh. 890, keep your nose up, up. Feather your props. Landing gear down. Turn in your wings. You're a disgrace to the Corps. Attention all flights. Ooh, cold front is on its way. The cold front has arrived. Oh. 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 Where's my relief? Oh, there you are, Donald. Come on in. Here, give me a lunchbox. Hey, you take this. Maybe you can talk some sense into your duck pals out there. Why didn't I think of that? Did you know that peacocks on the Brown Sea Island Sanctuary in England are going bald because tourists are plucking out their head feathers? And there's nothing more pathetic than a poor, prematurely plucked peacock. Poo, pow, pity, pump. Hey, Hey, Groovy, you're just in time to join me for my weekly trip through Mother Nature's supermarket. I mean, everything grows naturally here. No preservatives, no artificial flavoring, and dig my crazy organically grown beads. Even my outfit was made without preservatives. Okay, bread. Ah, pumpernickel. Thank you, breadfruit tree. And if you really want to get together, there's nothing more helpful to groove on than naturally grown honey. Okay. Dig those vibes. Thank you, you crazy honeybees. Okay. Now, I've got to lay in some spaced out cactus milk. Ow! Groovy milk. But the dispenser's a bummer. Well, that about does it. Except for some watermelon from Farmer Duck's homegrown vegetable farm. Did you know that grasshoppers' ears are at the back of their hind legs? That's probably why so few of them take up tap dancing. All right, front and center. At ease, men. All right, it's good to see all my faithful forest friends. You're probably all wondering why the old forest ranger called you here, right? Well, what I've got to say is not easy. It's about hunting season. Oh, come on back here, you cowards. At ease. I told you it wasn't going to be easy. The problem is very serious. I mean, you all know what happened to the dodo bird and the passenger pigeon. Right. They're extinct. And looking at this group, I wouldn't be surprised if the same thing happened to you. Let's face it. How many bears do you know that are in the forest wearing blue coats? Look, you want my advice? Change it for a red one. Good luck. Mickey, it's very easy for you to smile, because who's going to shoot a 4-foot mouse? Fox? Fox, if I were you, I'd learn to bark like a hound dog. My friend, I want you to go out and find a nice, safe cave and hibernate for the winter. Donald, I don't know how to tell you this, but duck hunting season starts in about 10 seconds. No, oh, Donald, don't be a man. Don't be chicken, duck. Besides, the old ranger's gonna take care of you. Every man for himself! Here, Donald, hide behind this. They'll never get you. Ooh. Donald, at ease. It's over. Look. This is no safe place for a duck. Why don't you go back to your old job at Disneyland, okay? Okay. Did you know that the whistling swan has 25,216 feathers? Well, don't try to pluck one of them out, or he'll blow the whistle on you.
Here we are backstage of the Tanglewood Music Festival, ladies and gentlemen. At the moment, this year's guest conductor, Maestro Dominic Arpeggio. As you can see, the maestro takes particular care of his valuable hands. Now for the crowning touch, the all-important baton. Having made his selection, the maestro is at last ready to advance to the podium. Is in readiness, the audience expectant. And now the maestro is about to begin his first selection from Giuseppe Verdi's Il Trovatore, the familiar and ever popular Anvil Chorus.
Thank you.
Did you know that a lion's roar is so loud it can be heard 10 miles away? Maybe that's why you don't see too many lions in a library.
Time for the animals, and they howl.